yourself and not only attack yourself, but touch yourself in the three sensitive areas, the eyes, the nose, or the mouth. That's how the second way of infection. The virus cannot go through the normal intact skin of a human being. And actually, it cannot not even go through other soft parts of the body, because I was worried about that, whether it could go through other soft parts of the body. But scientists have told me that it only goes for the soft parts on the face, the nose, the eyes, and the mouth. It only goes through the soft parts of the human face mentioned above. Three, although the healthy people afflicted may survive, although the healthy people attacked by this virus may survive, it can kill a lot of people that already have other medical conditions, such as AIDS, blood pressure, I'm told even pregnancy, somebody mentioned, diabetes, sickle cells, cancer, the elderly, etc. In China, its cure rate was 4%. However, in Italy, it is now 11%. And in Spain, the cure rate is now 8.4%. It even kills the young people in some cases, like the young doctor, Li Wenliang of Wuhan in China, who first identified this problem. He was only 33 years old. Given its spread methods, sneezing and coughing by an inconsiderate and careless person in a cluster of people bunched together, as well as an individual's own carelessness of touching the soft parts of your body, the eyes, the nose, and the mouth, without washing your hands or sanitizing them first, after careful study, we decided that this virus will spread fastest if it gets into large concentrations of people, some of whom may be behaving inconsiderately or carelessly, as stated above. What I'm saying here is that this virus would not amount to much if people were not careless. This is my conclusion. I have studied, I have interrogated these scientists, and this is my conclusion. This virus would not do much damage if it was not the carelessness of people. Don't go into a group of people if you have a cold. Stay at home. Because you don't know what that cold is about. And you don't get near somebody who has got a cold during this time of this trouble. But thirdly, do not touch your face carelessly. That's all. There's nothing else about the virus. However, but because people are careless, that's how it becomes a big problem. And because of that, knowing that many people don't bother, we therefore, and we knew that if it gets into big groups, it will spread like wildfire into concentrated human groups. We therefore adopted the strategy of dispersing any concentration that may provide fuel to this virus. In my address of the 18th of March 2020, I put out 13 actions that dealt with this problem in part, as well as other associated matters. The 13 measures announced then were: close all the education institutions, which accounted for 15 million Ugandans. Those ones were closed, because those were waiting, were big groups waiting to be infected, because there are so many, and many of them are carefree. So we knew this was a very dangerous entry point. Two, we suspended communal prayers in mosques, churches, or in stadia and other open-air venues. I'm very glad the religious leaders also agreed that God was in all places, omnipotent, omnipresent, that we can pray at home. So we dispersed the prayer groups. We stopped all public political rallies, cultural gatherings, or conferences. Number four, we banned Ugandans from moving to or through Category 1 countries that had had large number of corona cases by that time. Number five, we allowed returning Ugandans, provided they underwent mandatory quarantine at their own cost for 14 days at a venue identified by the Minister of Health. Number six, we allowed the non-agricultural gathering points to continue, but with SOPs, standing operating procedures, put out by the Minister of Health. And these gathering points were factories, hotels, large plantations, markets, tax parks, etc. Number seven, we discarded the hexagonal, I've called it hexagonal because it is six-sided, hexagonal, extravagant Ugandan-style weddings. However, we said if you are in a hurry, we encourage the couples to go for the scientific weddings by the actual stakeholders, accompanied by a few people. Not more than 10. We said God would definitely receive you. You didn't need a whole crowd to accompany you into holy matrimony. What was crucial was the bridegroom, the bride, the best man, I don't know whether he's mandatory or optional. The other one is what's called matron, and the priest, that's all you need. And the matrimony will be done. Number eight, burials could not be postponed, but it should be for a few people, the immediately concerned homestead. Number nine, with the 33 million farmers, according to the census of 2014, there was no problem because they are dispersed in their farms, plantations, etc. The only issues to deal with here were the monthly or weekly cattle auction markets, Ebukomera, and Obutare, weekly food markets. These were suspended. The Ebukomera were suspended, and so were the Obutare. The Obutare are the weekly food markets. Ebukomera are the monthly cattle auction markets. They are suspended, those ones. Number 10, at that time, we thought that we could continue with the public transport systems of buses, minibuses, taxis, border, etc., provided they were given special standing operational procedures. They were given rules of do's and don'ts. 11, the discourse, the dances, the bars, the sports events, the music shows, the cinemas and the concerts were all suspended. Number 12 was hygiene and enlightened behaviors, as opposed to kafir ones, of not coughing or sneezing in public, no spitting, washing with soap and water, or using sanitizers, regularly disinfecting surfaces such as tables, door handles, etc., and not touching your eyes, your nose, or your mouth with contaminated and unwashed hands. And these were the 13 points which I announced on the 18th of March. We quickly, however, learned that some of the actors were not obeying these measures, and that, for instance, the returnees from abroad, from the high-risk countries, were escaping from the quarantine even when it was mandatory. The ones in self-quarantine were also escaping, e.g. the Chinese that were arrested on the Congo border in Zombo, or the returnee from Kisumu, that is the father of the Iganga baby that turned out positive, that went into hiding. These gaps could cause us serious problems. These gaps were undermining the strategy of denying the virus the fuel that it could ignite and sustain its expansion by ensuring that there is no matchbox and there is no dry grass, no virus, and no concentrated masses of Ugandans. Therefore, on the 21st of March 2020, on the 41st anniversary of the Battle of Lugando, I announced two new additional measures. One, stopped all passengers coming into Uganda by air, land, or water. This affected incoming planes, buses, taxis, or boats. Number two, we also prohibited from entry into Uganda the pedestrians or people on bicycles that were coming from the neighboring countries. In all these measures, we are careful to clearly state that cargo planes and cargo vehicles within Uganda and between Uganda and the outside world should continue with only the crews for the aircrafts. Cargo must continue. Cargo. Emigugu. Mizigo. Lazima iyo iendelee. Then on the 21st of March 2020, we announced additional measures as follows. That was later than the 21st. There must be some correction here. On a later date than the 21st, we announced additional measures as follows. All public passenger transport vehicles are stopped, and those were taxis, coasters, buses, passenger trains, tuk-tukus, the tricycles, and border-borders. Secondly, in order to scale down the numbers of the population in the markets, we announced that only food sellers should remain in the markets. the non-food sellers should suspend their activities. However, that time we said private vehicles could continue, but with only 3 people maximum per vehicle. However, ambulances, army vehicles, garbage collection vehicles, etc. would continue. Since that time, we have been monitoring the situation. It was good we took all these measures. However, there are still windows through which the virus can continue to spread. As of today, the 30th of March 2020, 31 Ugandans and 2 Chinese have been confirmed as being positive with the virus. Almost all of them are imported cases by Ugandans returning from mainly Dubai, UAE, but also from Europe, the USA, and Afghanistan. Only 3 are the ones that received it from the importers. These 3 are the wife and daughter of the massacre man and the baby from Iganga, whose father had returned from Kisumu in Kenya. Out of the 33, the number of 8 were intercepted at Entebbe in the quarantine who was detected by the temperature monitor, and another 7 that were first identified by the temperature monitoring system. This means that 14 out of the 33 had already entered the city. They had already come in the compound, and some had even entered into the house. Since we did not detect them at the entrance, or they escaped from the quarantine holding ground. How many other Ugandans did they interact closely with the possibility of infecting them? That is what we need to discover, and we need to do it soonest. It is good that those who start feeling the symptoms report themselves, like the case from Hoima did. However, this disease has 2 characteristics that make work of fighting it tedious and quite challenging, and need maximum vigilance. One characteristic is that some of the infected people may not feel sick and may not even know that they are infected. Yet, they will continue spreading the disease, of course, through the carelessness of the general population of, for instance, polluting surfaces and touching oneself in the soft parts of one's body, which I've already mentioned, the eyes, the nose, and the mouth, and sitting very close to one another, even if the infected person is not coughing. After further careful analysis, we have come to the conclusion that to be on the safe side, it is better we err on the side of caution, we make a mistake on the side of caution, than to wait for a possible situation like of some countries where 1,000 people are dying per day from this disease. The second characteristic of this virus is that those that are infected, even when they survive, they take long in hospital. In China, one case took two months. This has caused the filling up of all the hospital places, even in the countries with advanced medical systems until a situation where the medical authorities have to decide on who should be allowed to die and who should not, because they have nowhere to put them in the hospital. Therefore, with these cases that entered in the House, we should not wait for that situation to develop. Incidentally, we now have under quarantine a total of 839 persons. Even those that are alleged to have escaped from the quarantine have all come back. How many people had they interacted with, and how careless are they with the sitting close to one another and with the carelessly touching their soft parts? We don't know. We therefore think that there is less risk in taking the risk of the bitter medicine of maximum restrictions for a limited time